Well, okay. So now today we are going to discuss the third part of Anglo-Maratha War. You know, it is a war which was fought for a very long period, around 8 years. I hope you are able to see me and the file as well, Vishwajit.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Just
Hello.
well, so we have discussed that in around 1780, Nana Fadnavis, he managed to bring Hyder Ali together with Maratha. He also brought Nizam and Bhosle, but Nizam and Bhosle Hastings, managed to separate them from their alliance. Nizam was given his Northern Sarkar back, and he was pacified. And similarly, Bhosle were given 50 lakh rupees in cash and kind. So Bhosle also did not join the war. And mostly the people who fought war against the British were Marathas and Hyder Ali. Hyder Ali, he fought in the south, and the Marathas, and among the Marathas also, it was mostly the responsibility of fighting the war was taken over by Mahadaji Shinde in the north, and the army of Pune Darbar in the Bombay and Konkan region. Well, now as the war in Gujarat was proving to be indecisive, the British at Bombay, they were quite interested in capturing the fertile area near Bombay, so that they can get good supply to the Bombay harbor. Now, when Godard, the British commander in Gujarat, when he was fighting against the Maratha army in Gujarat, the troops from Pune, that is Peshwa's troop, they were sweeping down in Bombay and surrounding region and devastating the region around Bombay. And in 1774, in the beginning, the Britishers, they have captured Thane. And they were hopeful that after capturing Thane, we will be capturing some other important forts near Bombay, that is mainly Basin and Kalyan. And this Basin, which is pronounced as Vasai in Marathi, is very important. It was a matter of prestige for the Marathas, because that fort of Basin was captured by the brother of Bajirao first, Chimaji Appa, from the Portuguese. And that was a very long drawn war against the Portuguese, because Portuguese were having a very advanced artillery. But Marathas, at the cost of lot many people, they captured this fort, and that was considered as a matter of prestige. Now, though the Britishers, they were trying to expand in the area near Bombay, it was Maratha governor of Konkan, Visaji Pant Lele, who very bravely defended the area, and Britishers did not get any chance to expand their kingdom in and around Bombay. Now, Godard, first who was fighting in Gujarat and leading the British army, he sent Colonel Hartley from Baroda towards Bombay. But in between, before they could reach Bombay, they were attacked by the Maratha forces, and they were routed, defeated. Colonel Hartley, he lost near about 500 men and 5 guns, and that were captured by Panse and Baji Pant Joshi, two commanders from Pune Army. And but the Britishers had one victory. From Thane, they suddenly dashed on Kalyan, which was a Maratha fort, and Kalyan was captured in May 1780. Now, Kalyan was a very important city for the Marathas, because that was near the sea coast and a very important center of trade, and there were numerous rich merchants at Bombay. So the British looted all these merchants, and they carried away all this booty to Bombay. The Maratha forces, which were sent from Pune to relieve Kalyan, to prevent Kalyan from falling in the hands of the British, were defeated by Colonel Hartley in May 1780. Now, Godard thought that his next strategy, as the war in Gujarat was not progressing according to his liking, and Raghunath Rao was also pressing British that fighting in Gujarat is not going to earn me the kingdom of Pune. I want that you should fight war in that region so that Pune can be captured and I can become Peshwa. So Godard was called by the British from Bombay, and he was called from Surat, and then he visited Basin, that is the fort of Vasai, which I told you to be a very important prestigious fort for the Marathas. And the garrison was so hard pressed, British surrounded them and cut off all the supplies. And the Maratha forces, they were marching from Pune to relieve the pressure on Basin. But before they could reach Basin, you know, the British, they took adequate precaution that the Maratha forces from Pune are not reaching to Basin. And here, before the Maratha forces could reach Basin, the in charge of the fort, Visaji Pant, he finally surrenders the fort on 12 December 1780. And on the same day when the fort was being surrendered to Godard, the Maratha army was fighting the war against the British army. In fact, this British army was sent by Godard to prevent the to reach the Basin, so that Basin can be saved. And here one important thing has happened, you know, at a distance from Basin towards Pune. That means if the army is marching from Pune towards Basin, they have to cross two hills, and on the two hills the British commanders, they mounted their cannon. And the one of the important commander from the Pune army was Ramchandra Ganesh. Ramchandra Ganesh has played a very important role in the during the time of Madhavrao Peshwa in re-establishing the Maratha rule in the north. So this Ramchandra Ganesh, the war veteran, he was sent with the army from Pune. And you know, they wanted to capture that cannons which were preventing them from going towards Basin. So they planned that early morning, when it was all foggy morning, because it was December and that is a mountainous region. In that foggy morning, Ramchandra Ganesh has planned that we will suddenly attack the British and we'll capture their gun. Because, you know, the British, they definitely had a much more advanced artillery. And the Marathas, in their what battle tactics against the Britishers or in any against any European, generally they avoided frontal collision because the artillery will roast them. So, they used to try mostly the guerrilla tactics. So, Ramchandra Ganesh, with his troop, he mounts, he climbs the mountain in the early hour on 12 December 1780. But when he reaches near to the cannon, unfortunately, the fog clears, and as the weather clears, the Britishers could see the Maratha army marching towards them, and they fired their cannon. Though the Marathas rushed towards them, unfortunately, a large number of Marathas were killed, including Ramchandra Ganesh. But this death of the valiant commander, very well-known commander Ramchandra Ganesh, has infuriated the Marathas, and later on we find that it is the death of Ramchandra Ganesh that has further united the Marathas. Now the Basin was captured, Ramchandra Ganesh was killed. Now the British in Pune and the Mumbai region, in that area, they were quite enthusiastic. They thought that now we can try to capture Pune. So with the intention to capture Pune, they decided that we should now march to Pune through Borghat. And Colonel Godard and Hartley, they were selected for this purpose. And they started from Bombay, and you know, they ascended the Ghat, and then he placed himself at Khandala in February 1781. See, I'll show you the map. This is Khandala, and this is Bombay, and here it is Pune. So it is not exactly midway in between these two cities. It is a little distance more. The distance between Pune and Khandala and Mumbai is little more than Khandala and Pune. Khandala is little bit closer to Pune, but it is somewhere in between. And this is all mountainous region. So this British army, they march from Pune, they marched from Bombay, and they took their position at Khandala so that they can clear the way, because here definitely the army was sent from Pune so that they can the Britishers can be prevented from coming closer to Pune. Here we see that Tadegaon where the Britishers were defeated earlier. Let me go back again. So you know, they took their position at Khandala, and from Pune, Haripanta Phadke and Parshuram Bhau Patwardhan, these two Maratha commanders, They march to stop the British. Tukuji Holkar also joins them from Khandesh. And Mahadaji, though Nana Fadnavis was very interested in protecting Pune, Nana Fadnavis requested Mahadaji that you should come towards Pune to protect Pune. But Mahadaji told him ki Malwa is also very important because this war is no longer limited, no longer confined to reinstalling Raghunath Rao from the British side. The Britishers were now interested in demolishing the complete Maratha power all over, and the Malwa was very important power centers of the Maratha. And if the army from Bengal is marching towards Pune, they has to cross from Bengal or from Allahabad. Allahabad was already in the hands of the British. So if the army has to march to Pune from this region, that is Bengal or Allahabad, they have to cross Malwa. And if Malwa is lost to the Marathas, definitely the Britishers will come very, very close to Pune. So Mahalaji disagreed with Nana, and he said, okay, you protect Pune with your own forces of Pune, and in any case, Tukoji Holkar is coming to support you. I'll protect Malwa. So he remained at Malwa with the intention that any army coming in support of the British at Bombay will be stopped by him in Malwa itself. Now near Khandala, as the British army was encamping, the Marathas, they again adopted guerrilla tactics. They cut the supplies of the Britishers, and Godard now could not progress towards Pune from Khandala, and it became very difficult also for him to come back to Mumbai. So I'll show you this map once again. This is Khandala in between, and from Bombay it takes around 153 kilometers, and from Khandala to Pune I think it is 100 kilometers or so. So now the British army was stationed at Khandala, and the army was sent from Pune, and there were a lot of skirmishes going on between the British forces and the Marathas surrounding to Khandala. And Marathas, with their guerrilla tactics, keeping safe from the British artillery, managed to inflict severe defeat on the Britishers and secured a large number of booty. Reinforcement that was sent from Bombay to help the Britishers at Khandala was cut off by the Marathas. They were dispersed by the Marathas in between. They could not reach. And Godard, he found himself quite isolated with his forces. And now he decided to retreat towards Bombay. During his retreat also, Marathas attacked them, and 19 officers of the British army were killed. 3,000 men were dead, and large number of people, 3,000 were either dead or wounded, unable to fight anymore. And 5,000 muskets, that is, guns were lost. And this defeat of very able, Godard was considered as a very able commander. So this Godard was defeated by the Marathas. He has to withdraw with a huge loss from Khandala to Bombay once again. And the Britishers, they lost their spirit. The war altogether has cost 1.25 crore rupees to the British. And as towards Bombay, Marathas have tried to prevent any supply reaching to Bombay. The prices in Bombay rose very high, and there was a famine-like situation in Bombay. Now, when all these things, a lot of things were happening simultaneously. When all these things were happening in Bombay and Khandala and near Pune, what is happening in Malwa, I'll tell you now. Now, Godard earlier, before reaching to Gujarat, before reaching to Bombay and marching towards Pune, he realized that until unless you break the Maratha power in Malwa, Maratha power cannot be broken altogether. And Hastings, he communicated this to Warren Hastings at Kolkata, the Governor General. And the Governor General, he sent Captain Popham with 2,500 men with efficient artillery so that the war front can be open in Malwa against the Marathas. And Rana Ab Gohad, who was against Marathas, Mahadaji Sindhya has put pressure on him to pay chauth to Maratha. So this Gohad, Rana Ab Gohad, who was dissatisfied with Maratha, he joins hands with the Britishers, and Captain Popham with his artillery and with the forces of Rana, they attacks Gwalior, the important station of Sindhya's. And at Gwalior Fort, there was one officer, Sarup Chand Gupta. He joins hands with the Britishers, and he shows secret passage to the Britishers. And British and the Rana, they managed to enter in the fort. The war was fought, and Kiledar Raghunath Ramchandra, he was killed in the battle. And many members of his family, they committed suicide. Women committed suicide instead of falling in the hands of the enemies. And Gwalior was captured by the Britishers. Kiledar, apart from Kiledar, there was Ambuji Ingle, the Maratha commander of the forces. He also fought very bravely, but finally he has surrendered. Now, in the northern region, as this was a very important victory for the Britishers, there were many rulers who were dissatisfied with the British, dissatisfied with the Maratha policies. They joined hands with the Britishers, and skirmishes were fought at the different places between Mahadaji's forces and the British. In one of the skirmish, in one of the battle, Colonel Kamak was defeated by Mahadaji. But Colonel Kamak, he withdraws to Bhopal, but later on he receives reinforcement, attack Mahadaji's forces, and Mahadaji was severely defeated. Then Ahillyabai Holkar at Indore, she sends her supporting army to Mahadaji, and army also came from Pune in support of Mahadaji, and after that the Maratha position in Malwa was recovered. Otherwise, after the defeat of Mahadaji Shindia, it was now believed that probably the Maratha influence in Malwa is going to be over. But now, as Mahadaji, he recovered his position and he inflicted very crushing defeat on Colonel Moore near Sipri in July 1781. In March, he was defeated, Mahadaji, but in July, he managed to defeat, because July somehow, because of rain and all, the artillery of the British, they could not move very swiftly. And Mahadaji, he took advantage of that situation, and Colonel Moore was severely defeated. Now, here Colonel Moore was defeated near Khandala. From Khandala, Colonel Godard has to withdraw. In Gujarat, nothing important was happening. The Marathas and the Britishers, they kept on having some skirmishes, but no decisive victory was in the sight. And Warren Hastings, 1.25 crores were already spent, and Warren Hastings now became very desirous for peace. He thought that probably we are betting on the wrong horse. Raghunath Rao is not in a position to pay. We are supporting him. On the other hand, we are spending a lot of money, and no material gain is coming in our hand. And Hastings now became quite desirous of peace. It was 8 years the war has been dragging on, one phase to another phase. And the company, the Scindia company, was also under the tremendous financial strain, and the defeat at Khandala and Malwa was also disheartened the Britishers. And through different people, now Hastings opened the channel of communication, channel for peace, through Bhosle. And now, Mahadaji, though he managed to defeat Colonel Moore, earlier he was defeated by Britishers in Malwa in March. And he realized that, we Marathas are not in a position to continue with the war for a very longer period. We don't have adequate supply. And the Britishers' artillery is efficient. They are having very trained army. Mahadaji, in any case, was very impressed by the disciplined forces of the Britishers. So Mahadaji was also eager for peace. But it was difficult for Nana Fadanvis, because it was Nana Fadanvis who brought Hyder Ali in alliance. And Hyder Ali was not willing to settle for peace, because in south, he captured large area from the Britishers. He killed large number of Britishers. Even Madras was also threatened by Hyder Ali. So he was not in to let go the area from his hand. And here Nana Fadanvis and Mahadaji, they had certain differences. But then Mahadaji told Nana Fadanvis, see, we don't have a lot of resources. Can you give me 15 lakh rupees? I'll continue with the war. I will even take my forces to Bengal to fight against the Britishers. And the Pune Darbar was also not in a position to pay money. A lot of money was already spent on the war. Bhosle was not cooperating with the Marathas. And finally, though Nana was not willing, but he has to militarily depend on Mahadaji Shinde. Nana was a very good diplomat, very good politician. But he was not a military commander. It was Mahadaji who led the army. So he has to somehow listen to Mahadaji. But before that, complete peace treaty between the Marathas and the British is to be, signed. There was a treaty between Mahadaji and Colonel Moore. Now we understand the situation that here Mahadaji, apart from serving the Maratha cause of Pune Darbar, he thought about his own interests as well. Because there was never a unified centralized command structure in the Maratha Confederation. Different Sardar, they had their own area of influence and they had their own interest. So Mahadaji, he was tired of war, so was Colonel Muir. So before the formal agreement between the Marathas and the British could take place, Mahadaji and Colonel Muir, they signed the agreement. Colonel Muir, he opened the negotiation apart from Warren Hastings, and he found that Mahadaji Shinde is willing to settle for peace, provided that Celesti, it is also called Sashti in Marathi, Basin, Basai, and other places near Bombay, which were captured recently by the Britishers, are restored to Pune government. And he opens negotiation in Malwa, and Mahadaji and Muir, they signs an agreement in October 1781. And according to this agreement, Muir and Mahadaji, Colonel Muir and Mahadaji, they should cease fighting immediately. Within a week, both the combatants should withdraw to their headquarters. You know, the Muir should go beyond Jamuna, so that, you know, Allahabad and towards Bihar and Bengal, or that is under the influence of the British. So they should go beyond Jamuna, Britishers, Colonel Muir, and Mahadaji should withdraw to Ujjain. Now, Mahadaji, as he was more inclined towards peace, he was also having a very respectable position among the Marathas. The Britishers gave him responsibility. And according to one of the clause of the treaty, Mahadaji should arrange peace between English and the government of Pune, as well as English, English and government and of Pune. Here, English do bar ho gaya. I just cut the one. And at the same time, Hyder and English. So, in the responsibility of settling the peace between Hyder and British was also given to Mahadaji Shinde. You know, Mahadaji himself had some correspondence with Hyder Ali, but you know, Mahadaji was fighting in the north, Hyder was fighting in the south, and there was a lot of communication delay. In between, there was Nana Phadanvis. Then one of the clause of this treaty between Mahadaji and Colonel Muir was that territories of the Marathas conquered by the British in Bundelkhand should be also handed over to the Marathas. And in addition, Mahadaji also asked that I will be entirely free in managing the affairs of Northern India, and especially that of the Mughal Emperor. Now, Hastings, he agreed for all these terms, and that had paved the way for the final treaty between the Marathas and the Britishers. Now, having agreed with Mahadaji Shinde, Hastings, he instructed all the British commander in the different war front to cease the hostilities against the Marathas. And the war was, you know, suspended. If not ended, it was suspended for time being. And the negotiation started for the treaty. So after months of negotiation, you know, during those days, communication used to be not as fast as we have now. So it took a lot of time. The representative will go stay in the camp of the Maratha commander. The Maratha representative will come and stay in the camp of the British commander. And then the meeting between the two commander will be arranged. They will put forward their demand. Marathas will put forward their demand. Sometimes they will break. They will not agree. And then the tension of war will be there. Again, they will come back. So, you know, all that takes a lot of time. So, in May, finally, the treaty was concluded. And according to this treaty between the Marathas and the British, all the Maratha area, including Basin, Basai, that was conquered by the British after the Treaty of Purandar, will be handed over back to the Marathas. Shasti and smaller island near Mumbai will remain with the Britishers. So Shasti has to be given away by the Marathas. Baroch, which was captured in Gujarat, will remain with British. And other area which was conquered by the British in Gujarat will be handed over to the Peshwa and Gaikwad. If it is Peshwa's area, it will go to Peshwa. Otherwise, if it is Gaikwad's area, it will go to Gaikwad. The British will henceforth will not support Raghunath Rao. And Raghunath Rao will be paid pension of 25,000 rupees per month by the Pune Darbar. Or now all the work of Pune Darbar was conducted under the name of Savai Madhora Peshwa. So that Peshwa Darbar will pay that pension to Raghunath Rao. And here one clause was put. The areas of the British that was conquered by Hyder Ali in the south will be handed over back to the Britishers, and the Marathas will ensure that is being handed over back. So we see the Hyder Ali, who joined hands with the Marathas against the Britishers, now become an enemy of the Marathas because of this kind of treaties. Nana Phadanvis was exactly fearing this, but Mahadaji Shinde finally prevailed. The Peshwa will not support any other European power. And here again, one more clause that the Britishers have put in very cleverly, and somehow Mahadaji surrenders to that because that increased his own prestige in the Maratha Confederation. Here, the clause is that the East India Company and Peshwa Madhavrao Pandit, you know, the Savai Madhavrao, the Peshwa that time, he was a young boy, of course. All the administration was looked after by Nana Fadanis in Pune. The East India Company and Peshwa Madhavrao Pandit request Mahadaji Shindia to be mutual guarantee for the proper observance of this treaty. If either of them violates the treaty, he will crush the aggressor. So, you know, the treaty was signed with Pune Darbar. You know, it is made like the treaty is being signed with Pune Darbar by the British, and Mahadaji Shindia is as a third party will be responsible. So, you know, the Mahadaji Shindia's position is become quite a separate entity from the Pune Darbar. So that Britishers have managed to you know, to drive the kind of wedge between Nana Fadanavis and Mahadaji Shindia. You know, now what is the verdict on the Salbai? Nana, of course, he did not like the treaty, but Marathas, they were military dependent on Mahadaji. And but Nana, he avoided to signing of the treaty because, you know, he was under the moral obligation, he was bound by the treaty that he signed with Hyder Ali. And as Hyder Ali was not willing to settle for peace, it was quite disappointing for Hyder Ali. But Hyder Ali dies later on, and in February 1783, that Nana Fadanavis signs the treaty. This was quite insulting to Pune Darbar, the portion around Bombay, like Sasti and Thane, which was conquered by the Britishers, remained with the Britishers. But Mahadaji, he thought about his own benefit and prestige, because more than Pune Darbar, he gave more importance to his influence in the north. And after this, we find that he reaped certain advantages. Now the Mughal emperor, he continued to remain under the control of Mahadaji Shinde. And Mahadaji, you know, the power center seems to be now shifting from Pune to northern India once again after this Salbai treaty. Now, general reflection on this war is that the war, it displayed that Maratha nation is still vigorous. They still have a lot of good commander and good diplomat. Like Nana Fadanavis has shown his diplomatic skill by bringing together the four powers. Sagacity of Nana and generalship of Mahadaji was highlighted, underlined during this all campaign. And Mahadaji, during his fight, he realized the importance of Western military. So after this, he vigorously tried to bring the Western French trainer specially to train his army. And his army was very efficient, which was destroyed during the Second Anglo-Maratha War. During the Second Anglo-Maratha War, we will find that this Mahadaji's army was the main target of the Britishers. Of course, Mahadaji was no longer there, and his successor was not as good as Mahadaji. So under his successor, this Mahadaji's army, which he built very patiently after this war, was lost. Now, Raghunath Rao, the mainly responsible person to instigate the war, to go and take shelter with the Britishers, and through it is by Raghunath Rao that the Britishers got somebody in his hand with him they can play and intervene in the Maratha kingdom, Maratha empire. This Raghunath Rao, he died at the age of 1783. Later on, he became he was no longer important in politics after this 1781, after this treaty, 1782, and he was losing all the vigor of his body because of overindulgence, and he remained with the Britishers, cursing them that the British are not helping him. And finally, this Raghunath Rao dies in 1783. So this is the first Anglo-Maratha War. Sorry. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me. First Anglo-Maratha War is very big, covers a period of eight years, and having lot many episodes in between, there were period of peace. And in the next class, we will continue with the second Anglo-Maratha.